Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's look at creating photo slideshows in Keynote. Slideshows continue to be a very popular topic at MacMost. A lot of people ask about them. If you go back to episode 203, I show you 10 different ways to create slideshows. But the most powerful way to create slideshows, the way I do it when I need to, is to use Keynote. Keynote is a very powerful presentation tool unless it has lots of different options for you when you're creating slideshows. You can put the photos in many different ways, have many different transitions between them, have complete control over how they're presented. And you can also put extra stuff on them like text and shapes. Let me show you. All right, I'm going to create a new presentation here to start with. I'm just going to use a plain black background. And the first thing I'm going to do is I want to shrink this down so I can see the entire slide here, sort of 50%, so I can see the area that will be presented. I also want to bring up the inspector and look at the document settings here and then go in and make sure that the slide size is correct. So I am going to be presenting a widescreen 1280 by 720, so that's what I'm going to leave it at. But you might want to change it to something else or use a custom size. So that sets up the document. Now I need to bring in the photos. So I can do this one of many different ways. What I want to do right now is use the media inspector and the media browser here and bring in some photos from iPhoto. So you can browse through this, bring some photos. I'm going to select a whole bunch here from an iPhoto event. And I'm going to drag them into the side here to make an individual slide out of each photo. Now notice if I just drag it over here, it's going to put it as sub-slides under this first one. If I go all the way over to the left, you can see it's actually going to move that blue arrow over, meaning it's going to put them at the top level. And it's going to import them all in, and each one will be its own slide, as you can see here. Now I want to get rid of this intro slide here, or maybe you don't want to. Maybe you want to actually use it to put a title on there. Now I've got each slide individually, and notice that it's got these text boxes because the default template for each slide here has like a title and some text. So I can get rid of those by selecting them all, shift and select to select them all here, and changing the master to a blank, which will get rid of the text boxes that are there. So now I've got a bunch of different images here, each one on its own slide, and if I play it, it would just go through each one without any special transition or anything special on each slide. So the first thing is you can manipulate the images on the slides many different ways. So for instance, I can select this image here and I can shrink it if I want. So say if I didn't want it to actually take up the full screen, I can shrink it, I can move it around, get it there in the center. I can bring up the inspector again here and then select the shape area here and add a stroke, like say a picture frame to it if I wanted to. I could bring up the measurements and I can rotate it slightly if I wanted to. Do all sorts of different things. I could even bring in other photos, so I can pile a few photos on this one slide. That could come in handy, you know, if you want to show some photos and there's several that are kind of related and you want to show them all together. That's something you can't do with a normal slideshow presentation, but you can do it easily here in Keynote. Of course, the other thing you can do, and we can go over to another slide right here, is you can draw on a slide. So I can create a shape here and I can use all sorts of different things like say an arrow, and I could have this arrow in here and I could modify it, for instance. So make it thicker and longer, all done in the inspector here, change where it points to. I could add more shapes like say a circle, put that in here, change it to no fill but with a line there so I could highlight something. So now I've got like a circle, I can circle something. I can put all sorts of stuff on a slide and then use them to illustrate things. And of course I can also put text on there just to illustrate something as well. Change that. Command T will bring up the text inspector and I can make it larger or smaller. Position it where I want, do all sorts of things here with the inspector and the text inspector, and go in and color up the stuff on this slide. And you can see it's all there. I go out of that slide to go back in and see the shapes and the text are all in there. I can even adjust the image. I could say select it here and then format mask to crop it to include only a portion of the image that I want. So there's a lot of different things. I can zoom in on a section. A lot of different things I could do here. And then once I have everything that I want, I can then add transitions between the slides. So for instance, I can just grab all the slides here. just Command A to grab them all after I've selected one. And I could add a transition, bring up the inspector, and then go to the slide inspector and add a transition right here. So I can say, let's go to the object push transition. I can set some parameters for it. And I just set it for all of the slides. So you could see that each slide here, if I go to play it, is going to push the next one. But I didn't have to set it for all the slides. I can go into each individual slide and then I could change it. So here I look at each one and I can change it for just this one from object push to perspective. So I can vary which transition goes from slide to slide. Another cool thing about creating slideshows in Keynote is it's very easy to rearrange them. You can see I can just drag and drop slides here and I can group a bunch together. So I could put like this one underneath that one and this one underneath that one, and then I can move them together as a group. So there's lots of cool things you can do to organize your slides, get them all together. You could even, of course, build in the how things are revealed on certain slides. So for instance, on the slide that we were editing earlier, here I've got all these different things like text and such. So say if I wanted this arrow to appear later, I can change the building order for each of these objects here. So I could select, each object to appear in a blast. So this line that I've selected is now going to blast in, which means that when I look at the slide first, you can see the arrow isn't there, and then it appears when I advance to the next slide. So you can do that to say have a show a photo and then the next slide, it's the same slide, actually have an arrow or some text appear. So you can kind of build up the story there as you present. Now, so many different other tools that you can use. As I said, check out episode 660 for using Magic Move to animate images moving from slide to slide. Check out Smart Builds 257 and 735. Check out export options. If you want to export this and not present it in Keynote as you would say on a projector, but export it as a video of some sort, check out episode 463 and also 708. One of the most important things to realize is that this is really a creative tool when used in this way, which means that you shouldn't wait until you need to build your next slideshow and have 10 minutes to do it in to try it. You should try it now. Try playing around with it, learning new things. It's kind of like if you're an artist and you want to paint something. You don't wait until you need to paint something. You practice and experiment and play with the tools to see how you use them so that when you actually need to do something, you have some experience. So I encourage you to play around with Keynote and learn all the different features. It's a very deep tool. It's not as simple as, say, creating a slideshow in iPhoto where you can pretty much learn everything there is to learn in about 10 minutes. Here you can work for hours and still be investigating some of the different transitions, techniques, and things that you can do with different slides. So play with it, have some fun, and use it as your slideshow presentation tool. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. Want more video tutorials? Just go to MacMost.com, click on the videos link at the top of the page, and then you can view all of the hundreds of MacMost videos by category.